So who can become a data scientist? And here we are talking about data science, right? So data science. So before we talk about data science, or you want to understand the part, the science, you have to understand what is data and why is it important. So we'll talk about data. And today, let me tell you that when we talk about data, it's all about big data. So what is exactly big data? And then we will talk about data science, but before that, data analysis. What is exactly the meaning of data analysis? Because, you know, like people ask me this question, like, yeah, we are talking about data science, but what is exactly data analysis? So we'll talk about this. And to get a very clear picture about data science, we have to look at the four pillars of data science. So data science is a beautiful structure. You can just imagine as a beautiful building and in its foundation. So there are four pillars. So it's standing on four pillars. So we'll talk about the four pillars of data science. And definitely, you know, you might be curious to know the responsibility, the role and responsibility of a data scientist. And then we'll be comparing data scientists with data analysts, data scientists, and data engineer. And here we are talking about analytics. So I'll talk about what is analytics and the levels of analytics, and then the job opportunities. And the last part, definitely the Q&A. But in between, you have any questions, you're most welcome. You can ask me. I would say that better you directly ask me the question. Some people try to write the question in the chat box. Yeah, you do that also. But if you can directly ask me the question during the session, if you want to ask question, please ask directly. And if you really want to ask the question by writing the question in the chat box, then please at the end, okay? At the end. So yeah, before I begin, I would like to know, are you people excited to know more about data science and to learn more and ask questions? Yes, are you excited? I need to get response from somebody.
Yes, sir.
Great, good.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You know that when you are excited, then I'm double excited. So let us make it this more interactive session, okay? I know that you are excited. That's why you are here. You are giving your precious time here. So I understand, but I just wanted to hear from you people that you are really excited. So mashallah, good. So is it clear the pattern? Like this is a session, okay? Before that, like just a quick quiz. Like anybody has got knowledge about data science already? Have you done some course? Because you know that people attend my session even after completing some courses, some online courses here and there. Is there anybody there in this right now in this demo session who has already completed data science course?
No.
Yeah. So if yes, you tell me. Okay. And fine. Anybody without any knowledge about programming? Anybody without any knowledge about computer programming? Any at least one or two person don't know anything about programming?
I don't know.
Good, very good. Yeah, no problem.
I don't know.
Yes, so we are not expecting anybody, so don't worry about that, okay? So don't worry about, like, even if you say I have no background in mathematics, I'm not in touch with mathematics, no problem, okay? Okay, I think with this, let's move ahead and talk about the first thing about data scientists. You know that, like, if you look at this question, who can become a data scientist? So simple answer is any graduate can learn and become a data scientist, okay? Maybe some people, you can argue with me that, like, you know, because if you try to search or research online, you may come across some people are asking you need to have a statistics degree, at least MSc in statistics or PhD to become a data scientist. So no, we are talking about applied data scientist. An applied data scientist is the one who solves business problems, okay? So for an applied data scientist, No problem. You don't need to be expert in mathematics, or you don't need to have a strong background in programming, or anybody, even graduate, any graduate, like BCom guy, BCom, BCA, BSc, of course. A lot of my students, they were just BCom background and they have successfully completed data science course. Even they started their career as a data scientist from the internship, okay? So absolutely no problem. But related to this, if you people have any question, any concern, you can ask me now or later at the end in the Q&A session, you can ask me, okay? So yes, any graduate can. The reason, quickly I'll tell you that you said how is it possible that any graduate can learn? You know, because I would like to write down here. Because today, like, you know, the tools, we have so many easy tools are there. You heard about the programming part, like, you know, basic Python are very simple user-friendly tools are there. And this tool come with all built-in features, which is going to make data science very interesting and easy. Okay. So first of all, let me tell you one thing. This is, we are talking about applied data science. Okay. Applied data science. So because of that, like, you become applied data scientist. Okay. Can you people see this screen when I'm writing? Because I have changed my screen. I'm writing now. Is it
yes,
you?
Sir.
You can see, right? What I have written, can you read this for me, please?
Applied data science.
Sometime, you know, because I'm using Zoom, right? So sometime when I switch, so the screen doesn't get changed, actually. So that's good, actually. So when I ask you, good, actually. So thanks for letting me know that, like, you know. So applied data science is the one who solve business problem, okay? So you don't do research. You know, research data science is all about, you're doing research onto machine learning, or how you can solve, how you can apply. Yes. So basically applied science is the one who solve business problem. Okay. So this is all about solving business problems with data and tools. Okay. So this is simple definition, actually. That's all about applied data science. So why any graduate, like, because, you know, availability of today, you know, the tools, a lot of open source tools are there, like something like Python, R, and it comes with, you know, a lot of built-in libraries. Libraries are nothing but you can say collection of built-in programs, okay, simple programs. So this is going to make data science journey very simple, easy, smooth, okay? So because of, you know, this open source software tool, and we have got open data portals are there. We have got open data portals. Means you can easily download any data, that lot of data is available, open data portals, like USA data.gov and Telangana data portal is there. And there are so many from Kaggle is there. Okay. And you know, a lot of online communities there, online, you can say community support is there. So there are so many things are there, which is going to make learning data science easy. Okay. So that's why anybody can learn and become data scientist. So I just wanted to tell you a few points that, like, on what basis I'm saying that any graduate, and I'm not saying that a lot of my students just BCom guys and they have successfully completed, they started their, internship projects and they have successfully completed. Okay. And they are doing projects now. Okay. What is the prerequisite? You know, the prerequisite part, you know, simple basic mathematics, don't worry, we are going to cover the mathematics, the statistics part, the programming part, everything we are going to cover from the scratch, so you don't worry about this. Okay. What I would say that, like, the prerequisite part, the passion to work with data. Okay. So in the prerequisite part, I would just say that, like, you know, if you're willing to work with data, particularly numbers, you know, that's it, like, you know, fine, like, you're ready to start your career or your journey to become a data scientist, actually. So this is exactly the passion to work with data, to passion to work numbers, and the most important, the passion to solve problem with data. Okay, so this is what is required, passion to solve real world problems with data and tools. So if you are passionate to solve real world problems with data and tools, you know, yes, you know, I know that, like you may say, I at this stage, I don't know what problems are there. It doesn't matter. So you say whatever the business problems are there, whatever the problems are there. You know, if I'm saying world problem, you know what? Any problem, in fact, you know, the world climate problem, or you can say climate problem, or you know, traffic problem, or you know, so many problems, crime related problems. All these problems can be solved using data. Okay, so it's not just business problem, but any problem can be solved with data and tools. Okay. So this is basically prerequisite is nothing much. Okay, in the data science part, let us talk about what is data and why is it important. And then next we'll talk about data science. So data is all about, you know, numbers, characters, all those things. But something very important is data is considered as the new oil of 21st century. Okay, so can you see this screen? Data is the new oil. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
So do you agree with me? Data is the new oil.
Yes, sir.
But you know that like data is oil, but it's a crude oil, right? Crude oil. So you understand crude oil? Crude oil cannot be used, right? What before we use the crude oil, what we have to do?
We have to clean it, sir.
Refine, clean. Very good.
Refine, yes, sir.
Refining, cleaning. That is all about data science. Okay. So data is the oil, but you know, data, you know, data will not give you anything. So that's all about data science. So data science is a oil refinery factory, okay, where the data will be refined so that it can be used. Okay. So
that's okay, sir.
So data is a crude oil, which has to be refined, which you must refine. Okay. But this is something important. Now, you know, if you ask me simple definition of data is a collection of facts such as numbers, words, measurement, observation. So whatever you observe, a description of things, you know, in the world, you see everywhere there is a data. You know, when you're accessing your mobile phone, data is getting generated. When you visit any website, data is getting generated. When you're using any mobile app, the data is getting generated. When you're going to order anything, you know, online, data is getting generated. So huge data, okay? And you know, the data can be divided into this qualitative and quantitative, okay? So qualitative data is, you know, the words or you know, you can say that like, words or description of some things, but quantity data is purely numbers. So we are not only going to deal with numbers, but with words, the qualitative data. Okay. So for example, you know, if I tell you that like quantitative data is like price, quantity, these are all quantitative data. Whereas if you look at qualitative data is like, for example, you know, color, mood, you know, somebody, you know, or you know, for example, somebody writes some message. So whether message is positive or negative, okay. So these are all qualitative data, okay? Qualitative data. So we are going to deal with both quantitative, the numerical data, as well as the data which is called qualitative data. Now, why is data important? Actually, the data is important because the most important thing, you know, because it helps in making decisions or better decisions. Okay. So business can harness data to make what? Decisions about what? Decision about new customers, getting new customer, how to increase or how to increase customer retention, means how to retain existing customer, how to improve customer service, how to improve marketing efforts and tracking social media interaction, to predict the future sales, okay, or sales trends, okay. So this all thing can be done. That's why data is absolutely very important, okay. So just these are a few things. I'm going to share this presentation with you people. Don't worry, okay. If I'm going a little fast, don't worry. So I will share this presentation so you can go through. Data can basically help you. Data helps you solve problems and understand performance. Performance issues or improve processes and understand customers. Quickly, I'll tell you, you know, solve problems, you know, any business problem. For example, your business people will tell you that like our sales is going down, or to be very specific, we are unable to sell more in a particular region, particular city, particular region, or our particular product is not moving very fast. Okay. So this type of problems we can solve. Performance problem related to, you know, like our team, our sales team is the sales team performance is going down. Okay, how to improve the performance? Processes, like say, for example, sales process, purchasing process. You know, when we are going to sell, there are so many things are connected. Can we improve the process, you know, so that we can increase the productivity? Yes. Can we understand customer? Yes, we can understand customer. There is something called customer behavior analysis. So all these things can be. So for all these things, data is helping, okay? And you know, I told you that data is a crude oil, and for that you require data science. Okay, today we are dealing with big data, okay? Big data. So please, I'm not be spending too much time on big data, but today I'll tell you one thing. When we talk about data, it's all about big data. So to understand big data, you have to understand volume, the size, and volume is all about the size and velocity and variety, veracity and value, okay? So simply I'll tell you, when you have got huge volume of data and not only structured data, but unstructured data, okay? This is called big data actually, okay? And when the data is coming with a speed fast. So today, you know that images, RDO, you know, you saw the Excel, Microsoft, you know, Excel sheet. So the data in Excel sheet is well organized. So that is called structured data. But you have got audio, video, you have got text file, email, Word documents. So today, all this is considered to be very important. And this is, of course, this is all data, the digital data, right? So the variety of data, and you got terabyte, petabyte of data, and the data is coming very fast, right? The data is coming from social media, from your website. People are visiting your website, traffic, a lot of traffic data is getting generated. People are tweeting about your products and services on Twitter. So the tweet data is coming. People commenting on the Facebook page. So that data is coming. So that's called the velocity, okay? So let me again tell you one thing, that today when we talk about data, by default, it is big data, okay? So yes, we are learning big data only, okay? Okay, what is data analysis? So data analysis is the process of right from inspection, cleaning to transforming, okay, and modeling the data, okay? So the ultimate goal is to make the data useful, which is going to ultimately help in decision-making process. So what is the purpose of doing data analysis? So we take data and we do data analysis to help management or any stakeholder in making decision based on data. This is exactly called data-driven decisions, okay? Data-driven decisions. But you know, you cannot take data and you cannot use it to make decisions. So it has to be inspect, clean, transform, and model. Okay, so this part, anyway, we'll talk more in detail. Now coming to something very important, what is data science? The simple definition is that data science is all about, take the data and make it like, or convert into actionable insight from raw data. Okay, so actionable insight, and which is going to help the management or decision maker in making data-driven decisions, okay? You know, more technically, if you want to understand data science, so data science is a combination of computer science. Computer science is all about, programming part, mathematics, statistics, and there is something called artificial intelligence, which is machine learning, and the business knowledge, okay? So I will tell you, don't worry about this. You know, at this point, if you're thinking that like, oh my God, math, statistics. So let me, at this point here itself, let me tell you that like in our course, we are going to cover all these things from scratch. So we don't expect anybody to be good in mathematics or statistics or programming. So don't worry, we are going to cover from the scratch, and you don't need to have very strong knowledge in mathematics or statistics, or you need to be expert in programming. It just, you need to have a, moderate knowledge, just a balance of all these things. If you really want to understand and appreciate data science, let us look at the four pillar of data science. The four pillar of data science are these. The first pillar is data. Okay, because without data, no data science. No science, isn't it? It's not going to work out. So the first pillar is data. And the second pillar is statistics, okay? So statistics, of course, I'll talk more about data, don't worry. The second pillar is statistics. Statistics is very important, okay? Yes. Statistics is a language of data. If you really want to understand data, then we apply statistics. So statistics is a branch of mathematics. In fact, it's called applied branch of mathematics. Okay. So statistics help us understanding data, okay? statistics we are going to cover in the course from the scratch. So you said that it's a very long bike. I studied statistics. If you have studied statistics in college, it's very good. Otherwise, if you are out of touch, no problem. So we are going to cover from the scratch, okay? There are some noises coming from, I think, some of the participants. Please, you try to mute your mic. Later, when you are going to ask question, at that time, you can unmute, okay? Please mute your mic. Achha, the third pillar is, you know, software tools. Software tools. In software tools, yeah, Python is there. R language is there. So Python, R, these are the programming languages. Very user-friendly, very easy to learn. Anybody can learn Python and R without any previous background, any prior experience in programming. Somebody want to learn programming, the best language is Python and R. Okay, without any background, you can start. I this is a fact, you know, nowadays from 7 years to 70 years, they are learning Python. It's a popular, it's a fact. So anybody can learn Python without any knowledge or already having knowledge in programming. So some people think that, like, I think to learn programming first, we need to learn C language, you know, that's gone actually. So you can start with Python directly, okay? And Python is such a user-friendly language, you can become very good also. So for data science, one of the most popular languages is Python. The second most popular is R, and they are open source. It doesn't require license. Means the license is there, but it is a free license, you can say. You don't need to pay for that, open source. And other software tools, you require Excel, SQL. SQL stands for Structured Query Language. And for data visualization, we require Tableau. Okay, so there are a couple of tools required as a data scientist. But let me tell you one thing. This, I have, you know, most of the people are focusing on this tool, but I've mentioned it as a third pillar. Because remember, the first pillar, data. The second is statistics. The third is the software tools. So the software tools comes as a third pillar. And then is all about artificial intelligence, okay? Machine learning and deep learning. So artificial intelligence is all about, like, machine learning and deep learning. So these are the fields of AI. So when you want to predict, you know, you want to take the data, past data, and you want to predict future. So there AI comes into picture, okay? So AI or artificial intelligence, that is basically machine learning, deep learning, has got many use cases, many applications. But one of the core application here is prediction. So you can take the past data and you can predict the future event. For example, you can predict weather, or you can predict sales, future sales. You can predict the customer behavior, you can predict. Your student performance, you can predict. So a lot of things you can predict, okay? So there AI comes into picture. So we are going to discuss in our course more in detail about machine learning, deep learning, okay? If you have more questions, of course, in the Q&A, you can ask me. You know, machine learning is a very interesting subject. So machine learning has got various branches, like you can see supervised, unsupervised. There is something called reinforcement learning. Okay, the downside, if you look at reinforcement learning. And this is all about algorithms, okay? So these are all ready-made algorithms are there. So we use this algorithm to solve our problem. For example, you want to predict customer performance or sales. You want to how much sale we are going to make, how much sale, how much particular item we are going to sell in the future. So for that, we apply various algorithms. So these algorithms comes under supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. So I don't want to go more into technical details, but this is all we are going to cover in the course, inshallah, okay? So regression, classification, clustering, dimensionality reduction. But don't worry, we are going to cover from the scratch and we'll try to make it very simple, easy. And you will understand, okay? Because we are going to make it simple, easy. Because we are not expecting anything from you as if you don't know anything, and we are going to cover from the scratch, okay? So, you know, this why machine learning is a part of AI, you know, artificial intelligence, and why it is called intelligence? Because this is intelligence. We human being, can predict, right? At this point, I would like to talk to you about data science. You know, I tell you one thing, you know, in our day-to-day life, we all, even, you know, our mothers, our sister in our home, Everybody, we are all data scientists. So do you people agree with me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Sure?
Yes, all of sir.
So mashallah, you people know. So you people know you are already data scientist. So inshallah, you tomorrow you come and take the certificate. You already done. So you are data scientist, mashallah. Good. Okay. So yes, you know why? Because of course you people understand. Whenever we want to buy something, for example, when we want to buy a mobile phone or when we want to buy cloth or maybe say bike. So what exactly we do? We compare with so many other products. We ask people, we gather data, and then we take decision, right? So this is called data-driven decisions, okay? So this is data science, of course, data science, right? We are doing manually. And here we are doing using some software tool. This is called data science. So we are also doing data science, right? Acha. When it comes to prediction, data science is all about taking decision or making decision based on data. And second part of data science is prediction. We are going to predict in data science. Using past data, we are going to predict the future event. But in our day-to-day life, we do that. For example, whenever we go out of home, we look at the weather, we look at the sky, and we say, is it going to rain? Of course, during raining season, okay? Sometime when you want to buy some, when you want to go to market, you look at the time and say, don't go this time because this time is more traffic. So when you're looking at the weather and you're trying to predict weather, when you're going to predict traffic, so we are doing data science job, right? So this is all about data science. So I always say that it is very easy for everybody to understand what is data science, because data science is not a rocket science, because in our day-to-day life, we are practicing data science. In fact, we are a practicing data scientist, I can say. Even, housewives, our mothers, our aunties, our sisters, everybody do that actually, okay? Everybody. So that's what data science is all about, okay? So we have natural intelligence. So we predict using our natural intelligence, and here we are using artificial intelligence. So that's the difference between artificial intelligence and natural intelligence. So as we take decision based on our past experience, here we are taking decision based on the past data. Okay, so that's all about AI. Now, the fourth pillar is the domain knowledge is very important. So I would like to talk to you about this. Domain is all about whether it is finance, HR, marketing, or you talk about this is the fourth, okay. This is the data, right? The data is coming from data because the data come from a particular domain. So domain knowledge is important. That's called business analysis. So here we are mostly focusing on digital marketing. Okay. You can select anything. Like for example, you're coming from a finance background. So you can apply data science in your own background, in your own field, finance or HR or retail, or somebody coming from healthcare background. You can apply data science in healthcare. So you can become a healthcare data scientist or retail data scientist or financial data scientist, or even you can start your career first as a data analyst, financial data analyst, healthcare data analyst, education data analyst, all this, okay? Okay, let's look at data science role and responsibilities. So this is just quickly to discuss. So as a data scientist, right from asking the right question, one of the most important quality of a data scientist is asking the questions. Okay, so you should ask good questions. So the discovery start from asking the right question, and then after that, based on that question, we create something called problem statement. Yes, this is the problem, or this is the concern which I want to solve, and to solve this, we require data, and then you have to acquire data. So acquire data, process and clean the data, and then integrate and store the data, and then start initial investigation. And this is what we call EDA, exploratory data analysis. Okay. And then there are a lot of things are there, like we build model. So for that, we choose particular algorithms and we build model. Okay. And we apply statistics, machine learning, all these things we do. And then finally, we measure our result to improve it. And finally, once we have done, then we present it to the stakeholder. Okay. And of course, based on the feedback, we make some adjustment and it's a repeated process, iteration we call. So we need to repeat this till you solve the problem or till you go to the next problem. Acha, on this part, as a data scientist, what are the main deliverables? I'll tell you. Look at this is something much better. So as a data scientist, the final deliverables are you need to build predictive models. Few examples here: sales prediction, customer churn prediction. Customer churn means which customer is going to leave the business. Sometime customer will leave, right? So in advance you can predict so that you can improve customer service so that the customer can continue. So customer churn prediction, cash flow, in future cash flow prediction, you can do that. Okay, there are two things are there. One is the predictive model. The second is building data products. So as a data scientist, you'll have to build data products. Example, recommendation engine or chatbot. Recommendation engine, I think you people have already experienced. When you buy anything on Amazon, they also give you recommendation. You know, when you want to buy this, you better buy this also. Or customers who purchase this item also purchase this item. You know, that like, you know, generally we say, you know, what you see, you buy. Okay. In Urdu or Hindi, there's a very famous saying, right? Jo dikhta hai, wo bikta hai. So here, that's all about the job of the recommendation engine. So it will show you what really is going on in your mind, what you really want to buy. But maybe, you know, it's not in your conscious mind. It may be in your subconscious mind. So that's all about the psychology. Okay. So they are trying to use psychology. And that's what like recommendation engine does the job. And chatbot is, you know, now, you know, most of the website now coming out with the chatbot. Of course, there are a lot of improvement is going on in the chatbot. Instead of some human being answering your questions, so the AI, artificial intelligence will give the answer. So as a data scientist, we build these products. And there are many other things out there. I just want to give you some basic idea about this. You know, we are talking about analytics. What is exactly analytics? Analytics are about using this software tools, processes, methodology to solve business problem using data is called analytics, okay? So I repeat again, set of software tools and processes, methodology, and using statistical technique, solving business problem is called analytics. So analytics has got different levels are there. So descriptive analytics is all about what happened, what is happening. That's all about it describe what is going on or what has already happened. But predictive analytics will go to the next level and it is going to predict what is going to happen. Okay, so what will happen actually, how much we have sold, how much we are selling, to how much we will sell. Okay, and then prescriptive analytic is something which is in highly demand, which require a lot of domain knowledge, the business knowledge, solution actually. Okay, so if your sales is going down, so what we should do about it? Particular item is not moving fast, so what we should do about it? Okay, or our a particular machine, engine, employees performance not good, so what the solution part? Okay, so it talks about the solution actually, the prescriptive analytics. So at three levels we can work. Okay, so let me tell you one thing. As a data analyst, mostly we work at level one, okay, data analyst. So at this point, I think I can tell you the difference between data analyst and data scientist. So data analyst work at the descriptive level, mostly building reports and dashboard, reports, I think you understand, right? And data scientist is going to work at level two, predictive analytics. But when you become an experienced data scientist, when you become a domain specific, like for example, you know, there is something called data scientist, but we also have something called digital marketing data scientist or financial data scientist. So when you become a domain specific data scientist, okay, like a HR data scientist or marketing data scientist, that time you have to give prescriptive analytics or you will be working at prescriptive analytics. Okay, so these are the three levels are there. Okay, if you have any specific question related to this, now you want to ask, you can ask now, or at the end in the Q&A part, if you like to ask. So yes, you can ask in the Q&A part. Okay. Okay. So these are the three levels. And Now, of course, I would like to go for your Q&A session. Okay. And so I would like to go for your Q&A. So, you know, I just want to, you know, get into some practical mode, and I want to hand over the session to our trainer, Mr. Muhammad. So he will basically show you the Excel, R, and couple of tools practically. But before that, you have any quick questions for me? Anybody has got any questions for me?
How many algorithms are there, sir?
I'll just answer your questions. 1 minute, huh? Okay, actually, I was just So basically, I was just talking to, you know, because I want to hand over the session to Mr. Muhammad. Okay, anyway, your question is that how many algorithms? Many algorithms are there. Only the main classification, supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. So for data science, mostly we are going to work with supervised learning algorithms and unsupervised learning algorithms. And in supervised learning algorithms, we have regression and classification. And in unsupervised learning, we have clustering, and there is something called dimensionality reduction. So I don't want to go to technical part, but I would say that the most important algorithm for building predictive model is supervised learning algorithm. Under supervised learning algorithm, we have regression and classification. Under regression, there are many other. Under classification, there are many other, like linear regression. We have got linear regression is there, and non-linear decision tree regression is there. Supervised support vector machine is there. Decision tree is there. Okay, we have got different types of algorithms. Naive Bayes algorithm is there. So there are many algorithms are there, and even new algorithms are coming up. Okay, new algorithms are coming.
Okay, sir.
So mostly we are going to talk in terms of. I would say that, like, you know, if you have good knowledge about almost 10 to 12 algorithms, fine, good. Okay. So, but under different classification. Yeah. Anybody, any question before I hand over to Mr. Muhammad for further technical session? Yes. Any question you have?
Yes, sir. At the end of the session, are we going to be data analysts or data scientists, sir?
This is a very good question. You know that, like, you can start your career as a data analyst or as an associate or junior data scientist. Okay. So, matlab, you cannot become, honestly, you cannot become directly data scientist. But there are some organizations, they don't prefer to take you as a data scientist. So they give you initial role as a data analyst. And then slowly they say that after, you know, a couple of months, once you have got good hands-on experience, then you can go to data science.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Sir, what is the difference between data science and data scientist, sir?
Yeah, I'll just come to you. Sorry, guys. Actually, I was just transferring this host to our trainer. Okay. Sorry. What's the question you asked me? The difference between what? Data.
Data science and data scientist, sir. What is difference between data science and data scientist?
No. Data scientist is only doing data science, right? So the person who's doing data science is called data scientist.
Okay, sir. So you are not going to be our trainer, sir.
No. I'm the trainer, and we also have other trainers. Okay. So I'm the trainer, and we have other trainers, because there are so many topics are there in data science. So, you know, because we are going to divide this, so you'll be getting the best of best. Don't worry.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any other questions you have? So now I think you can have a practice, because, you know, we have discussed a lot of theory. So I just want to I want you people to have some practical session on, you know, Excel, R, and Tableau. So you can find them. They're very easy, simple. Okay. Yes. Anybody has any other questions? Can we start a practical session? Just a quick demo. Can we?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just 1 minute, please. Okay. So just 1 minute, I think our trainer, Mr. Muhammad, will continue from now onwards. And at the end, if you have more questions, I will be joining in the Q&A part, okay? So please be there up to, you know, even if it is 9 o'clock or 9:10, 9:15, don't worry, we will be there to answer all your questions. Now, and I hand over to Mr. Muhammad. Yes, Mr. Muhammad, you can continue.
Thank you, Mr. Sheba, sir, for introducing me to the FSA demo session participants. I hope you guys can hear me.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you are still in Rosy mode, or you are still active?
Very much active, sir.
MashaAllah. It's very good. So this is what the prerequisite for the data science. So let me introduce myself. My name is Muhammad, and I have 6 years of experience, and especially in statistics. Okay. So basically, in the whole course, as I think you guys know about the course plan, what it is actually. Do you guys have any info how the course structure it is? What is the course structure you have? No?
Sorry, I have not gone through it.
Okay. So basically, actually, we'll be starting with basic Excel. So we'll be giving some basic concepts of Excel, because as we know that the data science is nothing but playing around with data. So playing around with the data, it seems you have to work on data. So as we know that Excel is a very good tool. Most of the people don't know the power of Excel. So that is why we are covering in this course. So we'll be going with the basic Excel first, and we'll be having some basic pivot tables and visualizations. And even though, you know, nowadays there is a data analyst job based on Excel itself. So most probably the people will discourage Excel because they know only it's nothing but a spreadsheet, but it's not only a spreadsheet. So basically, you know, Excel is a very powerful tool, but it has some limitations. So if the company is having some millions of records, you cannot go with the Excel. Okay, that is why we are covering Tableau here. Okay, so when you have any doubt, you can prompt me and you can ask me at any instant, such that I can clarify your doubt. Okay, so as you know that Sheba sir already discussed all the points regarding the data science, but even though my approach will be a basic on it. So why we are going for the data science actually? So what is the purpose of data science? Why the companies are focusing mainly on the data science? Why they want to go for the data driven organization, for the normal organization to data driven organization. Why the companies are going for this? Because, you know, nowadays data is revolutionizing the business, because this is the competitive world. Every company is striving hard to compete with other companies. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
So for that, data will give them the growth areas. That means if you do not measure what is going on in a company, if you are not going to measure, so how can you grow? In which area you can grow? So data is a fact here. So data will provide all the insights which are available in the company, previous transactions, you can take customer churn, the customers are staying with the organization or whether they are leaving with the organizations, if they are leaving, why they are leaving the organizations. So it will show, data will show the growth areas. If you do not measure any company, there will not be a growth. Okay, since I have written here, no measure is nothing but no growth. So basically, nowadays organization is moving or transforming towards data-driven organization, such that to have a proper forecast or proper business decisions, to take proper business decisions. Okay, so that is why data science is very important nowadays and it is booming nowadays. Okay, so what is a data analysis? What is a data analysis? So basically data analysis is nothing but cleaning, transforming and modeling. As you know, this is the definition. So basically when you get a data, it will not be in a proper format. You have to make data as a story. You have to make a data as a storytelling to the organization, because your manager asked you to draw the insights from the data. If you pull the data and if you give the data as it is to the manager, he won't be understanding. So you have to clean it and you have to transform into the visual format and you have to provide the dashboard such that they can take decisions. So these all are all tasks which you are doing. It's nothing but cleaning and transforming. You're creating visualizations and all this, which will make easy for your higher management to take business decision making. You can draw conclusions from it. Am I right?
Yes.
Yes. So that is why data analysis. And you know, before going to data scientist, you have to go through this data analysis, because nearly 70 to 80% will be working on the data in order to clean and in order to transform, in order to visualize, and then you can make the predictive models. So if you are very good to manage the data, then you can build a good predictive models. Okay.
Yes, sir.
This is the scenario behind, that is why, and most of them may have doubts in your mind that what is the difference between data analyst and data science, data scientist. Am I right? You guys may have, what is the difference between data analyst and data scientist in your mind? Am I right in this regard? So data analyst is nothing but, you know, suppose you have a higher management, so your management will come to you and they will ask you to, they will provide you the problems. They will provide you the problems such that you have to give the solution. This is the task of data analyst. That means, again, your higher management came to you and they have given the problems and they ask you to draw conclusions from the data. That is the task of data analyst. Whereas the data scientist won't be having any kind of problems. You'll be having only data. You have to raise your own questions and you have to provide the solutions. That is the main difference between data analyst and data scientist. So data scientist, what they do, they take the data, they collect the data, they will draw questions from them, their own, by having the data, and they will provide the solutions. Right?
Yes, sir.
So this is the difference, main difference between data analyst and the data scientist. So I think this is clear. At any point, if you are not understanding, just prompt me. And I am not going into the deep, because it's already been 1 hour of session, and I think it will be very heavy to you. So that is why we are going on the surfacial manner. So basically, the sir told me to take some practical overview. Don't worry, I'll give you a practical overview, but it's very simpler manner. Okay. So basically, I'll be showing what is R, what is W, and what we are going to do in Excel. So what you require, what is the prerequisites, what you require. So basically, you know, these are the things which you are seeing on the screen, statistical concept, computational tools, domain knowledge. So these are the things you can gain easily. The main thing which you require is you need to have curiosity and you have to stick to the course. So whatever we are dealing, don't take it lightly. Just practice. This is what we require. Your dedication is most helpful in this case. You can gain the skills. Your determination is mainly important here. So you should be very curious about data. Okay. So you can learn statistical concepts, computational tools, domain knowledge. Domain knowledge also, you can work with the subject matter experts. You can gain anything. But the thing is, you need to be very keen and you need to be very curious to learn. So these are the prerequisites which you require to learn data science. Okay, so statistical concepts, don't worry about this. We'll go by scratch and we are covering some 10th class statistics. It's not like highly complicated we don't cover because it's not required. So whatever you have dealt and you have already had the concepts in your mind, don't worry, it will be refreshed to you. Or else, if you don't know, we'll go by scratch. So no need to worry about this, what is this statistics and all this mathematics kind of thing stuff is going on. If you're thinking like that, don't worry, we'll be going with basics, okay? You'll learn statistical concepts and as we, you know, we are not going with the formulas, we are going with the applied statistics. Basically, you'll go in Excel, we'll directly type some name, suppose correlation equal to corel, that's it, khalas. It's very easy to understand. There's no difficulty in it, okay? So computation tools, basically here, what is statistics? It's nothing but collecting, drawing, and conclusions, analyzing, and all this. So I'm not going into much deeper. So basically, we'll be covering these all, Python, R, W, Excel, and SQL. So basically, Python will be discussed by the sir, and I'll be discussing R, Excel, and W, okay? And SQL will be also discussed by the Sheba sir. So basically, why we are going to Python and R? Why we are not only sticking to one particular programming language? Because R is very good at statistical computation. Because R is called language of statistical computing. Even though you will be discussing the statistical concepts in Python, but many companies, they are preferring R for the statistical computing. So in order to have overall experience, in order to have overall knowledge, we are covering R also in this particular course, because you should not be limited. You should not be limited only for Python. If suppose there's a requirement for R, even though you should be able to handle the things. So that is why we are considering R as well in our course. So because this is very good at statistical analysis. So, and as I said that statistics is very important in our whole data science journey. And we'll be discussing this statistical concepts in Excel, in R, and the visualization in Tableau. Okay. So I think this is clear. So am I boring you?
No, not at all.
Okay, so you will be having complex visualizations in it. So basically, I'll show the outputs on R as well as on Tableau, how you can go through. So basically, this is used for data science and all this. So let us dive into some practical overview. So let me show you the Tableau first. So basically, this is nothing but Tableau. So you guys can see, right? you guys can see this Tableau screen?
Yes, sir.
Screen? Yes, sir.
So basically, why we are using Tableau? So you guys have any info previously that there is a software called Tableau?
No, sir.
No, right? Not at all.
So basically, whatever we discuss in Excel, you can do visualization in Excel also, but Excel is limited to some millions of records. Only you can store millions of records. If the company is having more than millions of records, you have to go for the Tableau. It is very good for the visualization. So see here, just drag and drop. See, I'm removing this and just drag and drop. All are drag and drop. Such that, see here, it will show all the details. Suppose here we are taking country region. I have a data set here. So here, in this case, you can go with the mapping and you can create a dashboard. This is nothing but dashboard. If you click here, it will show here as well. See here, it is showing all the... So why we are creating dashboards? What is the necessity of creating dashboards? Because by creating this kind of dashboard, you can draw insights easily. Suppose here you can see the peak. This is nothing but number of employees here. So this peak itself shows that it is how many employees are there. Just click and just you can filter it. So it will show all the details. That means this is nothing but California, how much revenue it is generating and how many employees, such that you can take the business predictions. Suppose you have number of employees more in particular region, but the revenue is less. So you can cut the cost in that particular area. So with the help of this kind of visualizations, it is very helpful for the organization. So suppose here we have Garon. If you click this and if you click on filter, so it will show that particular, see here, we have 93 employees. So basically in the dashboard, it will show you the whole scenario. You can link, suppose you want to check the manager performance. Suppose you have given, there are many stores in a United States and that is divided into multiple managers. Suppose some 5 managers and you want to check the performance of the managers. You can show in the form of dashboard. That means manager A, he's having some kind of revenue and the number of employees under it. And you can go into the investigation. If there is no such response from that particular manager, you can go further into that further investigation. You can do further investigation on that particular region and about that manager, whether effectively they are working or not. So basically this will be covering all the, so with the help of dashboard only, you can draw the insights. So they cannot go into this kind of data. So here we are having, they cannot go each and every, such as Indiana, they cannot go like this. So in the form of sheets, in the form of visualizations. So these are the visualizations and these are the, see here, California is having more number of employees and whether it is worth it or not. So even that also you have to check, right? So here this California is having a lot of employees while compared to other. So meanwhile, you need to have the such kind of response or else you have to cut the cost from that particular location. So this is clear? You guys are getting it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So basically, this is nothing but the overview of Tableau. So you'll be having the visualizations like this, but you cannot go for the data cleaning and all this. You cannot perform in the Tableau. So in the Tableau, you need to have a structured data. So I think sir has discussed already what is structured data. So you need to have proper structured data in Tableau such that to have a visualization. So in order to make a structured data, you are going for the R. So this is nothing but your R. So this is C here. With only single line of code, I can draw this. I can plot this. So this is very complex actually visualization. So with the help of only single line, and don't worry, it's very easy. It's like, you know, normal English language. So basically we'll be having a lot of libraries. So some such as ggplot2 and some dplyr packages. So don't worry, it's very easy and you will be having fun. You'll be having fun. And one more thing, the practice is foremost important. So basically with the single line of code, you are having such kind of complex visualizations. So that is why statistics is nothing but language of statistical computing. This R is nothing but language of statistical computing. So don't worry, we'll go by scratch in this also. We'll go by scratch in Python also. You know, no need to have any programming background. Slowly you can learn. We'll go by scratch. Similarly, you can, I think you guys know some basic of Excel. You guys have any basics of Excel?
Yes, no, sir.
So pivot tables and all this, you guys know pivot tables, basically sort and filter, advanced filter, and we'll be going for charts, visualizations. So I think you guys have this info, this knowledge, what is pivot tables and all. Okay. So even though those who do not know what is pivot tables and what is how we can perform charts on the Excel and how can we sort and filter, advanced filter. So basic, we'll cover the basic things. Again, we'll go to the statistics, and statistics we'll be having again probability and probability distributions. How can we make conclusions from the data? So don't worry, we'll cover from the scratch, okay? So do you guys have any doubts in this?
No, sir.
No doubts? So you guys have a clear idea between data analyst and data scientist, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So just give me a moment. Let me transfer back to Mr. Sheba, sir. Just give me a moment.
So what about Python?
Hello. Yes. You were asking some question, Python.
Yeah, the practical thing of Python.
Generally Python is covered by me, so I cover Python. So.
Okay.
So you want to see practical Python?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just give me a minute. Huh? So okay. Anybody has got any other questions? Anybody has got any other questions?
Sir, are we going to learn artificial intelligence in deep, sir?
Yeah. For data science, it is required. And we are going to discuss in deep. Of course, we are going to discuss in deep. I can tell you that almost we are going to discuss 1 month.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So that is going to be definitely more in deep.
Okay. Sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you're welcome. I think I cannot share my screen. So I will share my screen and I will show you some Python part also. So Mr. Muhammad, I think he has to stop screen sharing, then I can share. Okay, now I think I can share my screen. Okay, can you people see screen? Please let me know. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you see this Jupyter?
Yes, sir.
You know that if you just go to Windows, and here in this Windows, you know, you just type Jupyter notebook, because the installation is also easy. So this is the Python distribution, okay? This is called Python distribution, Jupyter notebook, okay? So you just click that and automatically this will run. And now, I'm just going to select new and Python 3. And now we get connected to Jupyter notebook. This is called Jupyter notebook, okay? So right now, what you see, this is Jupyter notebook. Okay, this is Jupyter notebook. Okay, and here you can run Python code directly. Python code. So, for example, if you want to, you know, you want to see something like, for example, like look at that command print. So simple command, like, you know, welcome to Python. Can you read this? Can you see this screen?
This yes, command? Sir.
Welcome to Python. Can you
Python.
See?
Python. Yes, sir.
So this is a Jupyter notebook. It is very easy. You know, for example, if you want to analyze some data, that's so easy. Like, you know, you can import some library and you can do this, you know, simple, like any calculations you like to do, you know, you want to take some input and you want to perform the calculations. For example, if you want to analyze some data from some file, so just you can say import pandas ispd. So this is a library, library. This is called pandas data analysis library. So you this using this library, you can analyze data interactively. So for example, I want to create some data frame. Okay, so pd.read read csv, and here I would like to just show you data set. In this particular folder, look at this. These are the data set I have, like for example, customers CSV. So customer CSV is a file. And now we are going to read this. That's it, only two line. And now df.header, look at this customer. Customer ID, customer full name, city, and contact number. Okay, so you can see, look at that. So this is CSV. I think you know CSV stands for customers, comma separated values. And this is an Excel supported format. And this is a physical file. And now from this file, we can read this, we can see this. Okay, head is going to show you these initial five records, but right now in this file, we don't have much data. So if you want to read any file, you can read. For example, if I want to show you some other, like for example, total sales, for example. Yeah, you can see total sales is there, or, you know, employee, for example, employee, you want to read employee data. So look at this is employee. So employee number, full name, skill, experience, gender, salary, department number, rating. So in Python is so easy, look at that. So if you need to import the library, that's why I told you, you know, today, anybody can become data analyst or data scientist. It is because one of the factor is availability of libraries. So library is making our job easy, okay? So there are a lot of things to discuss. Probably I don't want to drag too much. So this is Python Jupyter notebook, and it is very easy to install and very easy to learn. I will just show you, you can install from here. You know, you can go to this Anaconda site, anaconda.com. And from here, you can download and install Jupyter notebook, okay? Anaconda, can you see this Anaconda site?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is the menu products, and select individual edition, products, individual edition. And then look at this, you just go down and download, that's it. Okay, you select download. And now what is your operating system? Windows, your Mac OS, your Linux. So if it is Windows, you can select 64-bit, 32-bit. You just click that and it will download into your machine and it will start the installer. And installation will guide you, which is a very simple, steps to perform for installation. And once it is installed, you can run the Jupyter notebook. You can just type Jupyter notebook here and you click and that the notebook will come. And I've already shown you this screen, you will get this screen. And then go to new and select Python 3 and you get this notebook. And here you can type the commands and you can run interactively. This is called interactive data analysis. So this is Jupyter notebook to analyze data interactively. So you saw R, I think you have seen R, right? R, Tableau and Python. So these are the tools which are very easy to learn. And if you give a lot of, if you practice and if you dedicate yourself, you can become very good also. So it's already going to be 9 o'clock. I don't want to hold you for a long time. So if you have any further questions, please go ahead. And you have any question related to the when the batch is going to start, the timings and everything, please contact Full Stack Academy, okay? So they will guide you. They will tell you about the batch timing, date, fees, and all those things. But any question related to technical or your career related, please ask me. Yes. Anybody has got anything to ask?
So, sir, are we going to learn all the four pillars of the data science in deep, no, sir, in this whole
Yes, course? Of course. Achha, let me tell you something very important. As you ask me, yes, you are going to learn. And one thing good that if you want internship, I can tell you it's 100% inshallah internship you will get. Okay. So we are giving you four pillars. We will teach you in all the four pillars. And at the end, we will give you project, the capstone project, which is a part of your course. But apart from that, you if you want to work in some long projects for your experience purpose, for your internship project, internship in your interest to work in internship for 3 months or 4 months, yes, you all those opportunities we have actually. Okay, so that later part I will tell you. Like once you have complete the course, then I can guide you about internship and how to gain real time experience, how to how to build your resume or your complete data science portfolio. Okay, so what are the different ways to get experience? Even we are going to tell you and show you how to clear certification, how to become certified data scientist. Yes, but anybody has got any questions further, please? Yes, anybody, any question? Is it fine? Can we conclude the session?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, everybody. Thank you, all of you,
Hello?
For attending this session. Yes, go ahead. Go ahead.
Can you explain about the salary trend?
Salary?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I can tell you roughly that in Hyderabad, in India, data scientists with 3 years, practically, I will show you. I'll tell you like what people got. So they got, almost 3+ guys, 16 lakh package, 16 lakhs per annum. Okay. And some people, of course, the range is from 12 lakhs to 18 lakhs. So depending on the company, but the package is very standard, very good for experienced guys. Even 1 year data scientists are getting 12 lakhs plus package. Okay. Depending on company. So if you have experience, 1 year's experience, 2 years, 3 years, so you can expect a very good package. Right now, there are requirements for experienced data scientists. But when you have no experience as a fresher, yeah, you can expect somewhere between 1 lakh to 3 lakhs per annum. Okay. For that, if you complete your internship, your chances of getting a fresher data science job will be very high. And you'll be getting a good pay, at least 1.5 to 2.5 lakhs per annum. But that is only for 1 year, 1.5 year. Once you pass 1 year, then I think you can have a very good package.
Sir, I am having experience into some other domain, like as a DBA. So after this course, do I need to join as a fresher? Or how my experience is going to become useful? Experience.
Great. Your name, sorry?
Zubair.
Zubair, there are two things I will tell you. If you are willing to apply data science in your own domain as an Oracle DBA, then you can show experience. You know, in Oracle DBA, we can apply machine learning, data analysis. Okay, there are companies who are using data science, applying data science for Oracle database or whatever the database you are working. Okay, so you can do prediction, performance prediction, when database is going to crash, how to analyze performance, load, all those things. But if you are going to apply data science in other domain, like say maybe data science or digital marketing, retail, then you have to start as a fresher.
Okay.
Generally, if you start in your own domain, then of course you can say experience. But when you talk about any other domain, you have to start as a fresher. But of course, they will consider your previous, if you have good previous knowledge, experience. They may consider depending on your domain, but for Oracle DBA and all that, the best thing I can say, you can start as a data analyst also. Okay. And try to see data science and all, most of the companies are looking Oracle DBA job or DBA with knowledge of data science. If you try to search this type of job, then definitely your current experience will be considered, of course they will consider and they will pay you more also. Okay. Are you getting my?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. Anybody has got any questions? Okay. You know, you have any question, you can ask, you can send me questions through our WhatsApp group also, because you are a part of the WhatsApp group. Okay. So any concern, any questions? Yes. All of you, thanks for attending these sessions. Take care. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
You're most welcome.
It's been a very wonderful demo, sir.
Okay, yes, thanks for your good nice feedback. So you saying wonderful demo, I became very happy. In fact, you made me made my day. Yes, mashallah, thank you. Okay,
thank you, sir.
Allah Hafiz,
thank you.